What's up with the collar you brought in?
Oh. This
it looks fucking dangerous.
Look, I only brought it in to say this. I have this little dog.
Yeah. Is it retarded, by the way? Did we ever get the answer to that?
No, he's not retarded. He's turning into quite a decent dog. Okay. He shits like...
When it's supposed to?
When he humps his back. It's just he humps his back constantly. He's taking shits. And he's a little dog, but he's taking adult shits.
That hunches back
and
shit.
We're just trying. As soon as I see him hunch his back, I want to kick him through a window. But he fucking...
That's just squeezing.
I'm trying to find the right food combination. Like, me and my girl are just trying to figure out the right ingredient, like the right food combinations to get his shit, like, perfectly pick up. Consistency,
yeah.
So to not mush it or not too hard, so he's straining, but we're close. But anyway, he'll shit.
What the fuck? That is brilliant. Why don't dog owners do that more often?
What do you mean?
Where you figure out what kind of food to give them so the cleanup isn't a hassle.
I don't want it to be a runny fucking mess. I don't want it to sound like a coin when it hits the fucking.
Yeah, you don't want it to just bounce off the floor, but you also don't want it to just be just. Fucking
pudding.
Watery.
I want to feed it. I want to feed it twine, so I can just pull it out.
Yeah, feed it Glad baggies too, so it shits in a bag.
So that's pretty fucking good. Man.
So it's a pain in the ass, but he's a Westie, so he's real rough. And I'm reading about him on the back end. I bought him because he was already spaded, and he was on sale and all kind of shit. And at the end of the day, these dogs are horrible dogs. Like, it's like Jack Russells, or they warn you that these dogs stink. And this dog, he sucks. He's exactly what he's supposed to be.
What kind of dog is he?
A Westie, West Highland Terrier. And he's just an asshole. But at the end of the day, I'm not the dog whisperer. I don't know how to snap. I don't know how to these things. When I grew up, if a dog shit, you fucking boot it in his ass and strangle it. You still loved it, but you beat the dog. You beat the punch that motherfucker wherever his kidneys are. You just fucking hit it.
It was put his nose in it.
You shove his nose in shit. No,
and then you smack him.
You roll up a Bible and you fucking hit that motherfucker on his eye. You roll a Bible up. And so he was just frustrating me. Just frustrating me with this. With this, I can't hit him shit.
Gotcha.
So I went to PetSmart.
Okay.
And purchased, this is PetSmart now. Reputable company.
Yes.
It's not, mind you, it's not fucking Vic.com or fuckthesedogs.com. It's PetSmart, where they have wonderful things, food and everything for your dog.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a case, and it's locked up. You gotta have somebody unlock it.
Oh.
It's just a bunch of training collars. And I bought one thinking, okay, let me just buy this and, it'll just help me out if he's doing things and I don't have to just, And I bought this collar and I tried it on myself and it has 10 settings. I tried it on 6. I put it on my knee and my knee stuck, my leg poked straight out. And I haven't shit on the rug since. But this fucking thing.
But you said earlier that you tried it once on yourself, you'll never try it again.
It hurts. It fucking hurts. So I put it on my dog once. Like, I just put it on just to see what happened. I pushed it. I put it on 5.
You didn't push it just to push it. Did you wait for the dog to at least do something wrong?
No, I tested it. And that fucker was on my lap. He jumped up in the air. And land it and start looking around to go, what the fuck just happened? Like, the look on his face, I threw the collar off of him and hugged him. I'm so sorry. Like, because the way he looked, the look was like...
Just like an abusive parent. You beat him up and then hug him. That's great, Patrice.
Like, you didn't... Like, the way the fucking dog looked, it made the only look that it could make that made me feel bad, which is... What just happened?
What was
not
that?
Not you did something to me, but it was just like, oh my God, that hurt.
Oh, Daddy, protect me from that.
Yes, and I just fucking held him for 30 seconds to like maybe 2 minutes. I'm just like, I'm so sorry. And I kept it. It's like $120. I kept it just to have it, just to say, this is so fucking wrong. It's just so wrong, this fucking thing.
Put it on some bitches.
Can we put it on you?
Put it on your bitches.
That's why I didn't,
No, we should do. I see what Danny's doing. I think we're on the same page. Yeah, we are. The virus should wear it and be punished if he doesn't come up with a fucking punchline, right, Danny?
Okay. Yeah.
Put it around his, like, calf. Yeah. Not his neck.
That's fine.
Oh,
just
God.
Put it on his leg. And then when he says something, when he doesn't come up with a punchline, you hit the button. And where's then the number goes up by one each time.
Could someone set up the microphone?
Start on number
virus,
one.
Virus. 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 You got to call for him. Virus.
Yeah,
virus.
Virus.
Virus. Virus.
Where is he?
We're all looking down the long hallway.
Let me put it on two.
Two? Jimmy, would you try two?
Yes.
All right, Jimmy will try two.
Where are you going to try?
Don't put it any higher, though.
Yeah, okay.
He doesn't trust him.
And one is a sound. This is the training technique is supposed to be. Yeah,
hold on.
Put it to the mic. It's supposed to be sound.
That's fine.
To warn them.
So one is no shock. It's just the sound.
No, it's two buttons. You go. Oh, it's like if it's doing something wrong, you go.
Like, hey, motherfucker!
Here comes death.
You know what comes next?
You know?
All right, Jimmy's putting it around his wrist for two.
For two.
This is two.
You don't feel it?
I'm sure I will on three.
Three.
Ah.
That's three?
He just goes, ah. Ah.
What does it feel like, Jimmy?
It feels like you're being pinched.
A pinch?
Hold on. Yeah, they use this in domination and shit, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Go to four.
Go to four.
That's unpleasant. Go to five.
Oh,
ow, that hurts.
I see the muscles in your arm just started flexing.
Is that actually twitching. Just shocking you? That's really weird.
It fucking hurts.
Here's what it feels like. It feels like the two pieces of metal are going into your skin and twisting. Like, not like you're being stabbed, but like someone has a screwdriver and just twisting. It feels like your skin is wrapping around metal.
Ah, jeez, that doesn't sound like
fun. If Patrice did six on his knee, I'll do six on my arm, even though it does hurt.
All right. Jimmy's six.
No, I'll go to seven.
Go to seven?
No, he went to seven. It's sneaky. Try to hurt the white man. Good.
Doing six?
Yeah, that's a poke. Good to seven.
I can see the muscles in his arms are contracting, which is funny.
Yeah, it's unpleasant.
Wow.
It's fucking...
Go to eight.
Wow.
Going eight.
I want to see what it feels like. Yeah, that one you really feel. That's like a whoa. That's probably for a bigger dog.
I don't know what it's for.
What would your dog be doing to deserve that?
That, like,
fucking your chick in the face? If your dog is holding your grandmother down and fucking her face, you hit him on eight.
You put him on? That's what I said. This thing is not a training tool. It's fucking cruel.
Does it at least come with instructions?
Yeah.
Go to nine. Fuck it. I'll try nine.
Go to nine.
Oh, my God.
Jimmy on nine.
I got to do nine right here.
With the dog shock collar.
Oh, what's it going
on his arm.
It goes up to 10.
All right, go 10, Jimmy.
No, I'll go 10.
10?
No, nine.
Do nine for
nine.
Ooh, fuck, man.
That's bad.
Yeah, I'm not doing 10. You feel
like...
Jimmy's
going to put it on his nipple in a minute.
No, that's too strong, but you definitely feel it, man.
It's
wow.
Look at my skin.
What's the matter? You got marks?
No, just little ones. Nothing major. Imagine. Wow. I think in domination they would use that, and they wouldn't tell you when they're going to shock you. I know shock collars.
Oh, my God, the anticipation.
Yeah. That must hurt, dude. I put it on seven on my leg, and I'm like...
It does. You feel... Kenny, you want it? Come on. Steve?
I'll try it.
All right. Yeah, of course you will. Watch. Yeah. Oh, I came on my leg.
Yes. Put it against my testicles.
No.
Steve's going to try the shock collar.
On his arm. I'm not
shock collar.
Huh?
I'm not pressing that button.
I ain't pushing no fucking button.
You ain't putting no fucking. You setting me up to kill Steve?
No, I just
took... I've done these before. I've had
myself.
Yeah.
Okay.
I've done this before. I fucking.
Why?
Because I've had dogs and I didn't want to do it to my dog without doing it to myself.
Okay. Uh-huh.
And then did you still do it to the dog?
Yeah, but it's a fucking heartstring puller. I don't like the way this feels.
But does it work?
Yeah.
The dog stopped fucking around?
Yeah. I would do if you told me not to do something and you had that, I wouldn't do it.
Yeah, I wouldn't fucking
But you still use it on the dog.
I wouldn't shit on the rug if you did this to me.
So, yeah, but we don't shit on the rug.
I didn't do it on the dog. What level?
What number you want, Steve?
Jimmy, what'd you start with?
I started with two.
Yeah, he just went from the beginning to go right to the top there, Steve.
No, start with a five. You start with a five.
Start with a five. Did you do it?
Oh.
Okay, there you go.
Yeah, Steve might have a thicker consistency, that big lebony skin.
Oh, sorry. See, I turned it off.
Oh, my God.
Oh, Steve got cocky. Put it on nine.
Yeah.
He really
got cocky. Hold on a second.
So I'll start. I'll go five back.
Put it back.
Going five?
Yeah, wait. Let me make sure. Oh, the warning's working.
The warning.
All right.
Jesus.
And it's a tingle.
Okay.
What number we're up to?
Don't. What the fuck did you just put it on?
Seven.
Okay. Yeah, I felt that one.
What number now?
Eight. Nine. I go nine.
That's what I did.
Right, we're going nine with Steve. Dog shot.
Whoa, oof, motherfucker. You can go ten. Go ten.
Oh, oh shit. Steve's going ten. Going ten.
Wow! That's a lot worse than nine, isn't it?
Wow! You feel your skin tightening, like Jimmy said, exactly around the electrodes, and that
and
is fucking unpleasant.
And this goes around the poor puppy's
neck. See, look at Steve's arm.
Where the throat is.
Holy
yeah,
shit,
yeah.
Dude.
That's still
freaking
spasming.
That is this imprint in your arm. Did you push it in that hard?
No.
Not really.
Yeah, I'm glad I didn't go to 10.
That's the skin contracting.
There's
around
a big difference between 9 and 10.
Motherfucker, you are not kidding.
I said I couldn't. It was so sad.
Where's the virus?
Get the virus in here.
With the virus has that.
I gotta do a joke.
Strapped to his calf.
No.
Right to his leg.
You want the virus?
Yeah, I think that would be hilarious.
Where's the virus?
But he gets it out. If he comes up with a punchline, you can't hit him.
Yeah.
What? Just whisper.
He's not coming in, apparently.
Yes, he is.
Why isn't the virus coming
in? Hey, virus.
Get the virus in here. If he doesn't want to do it, he can say that, but he has to come in and say that.
That's no saying no.
Where's the virus?
There's no saying no around here.
Let me go to Aaron in Texas while we wait for the virus. Aaron!
Yo.
What's up, buddy?
My girl name.
Dude.
Hey.
Yeah, well, I don't get my ass kicked by 10-year-olds, so, in the online gaming community. So.
Right you are.
I told you.
I can't deny that.
Hey, what are the chances if we put this thing on Big A? He comes out the perfect linguist.
Zero. He would just go, He would yell out longer.
And we know he can't yell stop, so.
Yeah, he has to yell stop.
Just an idea, guys. Just an idea.
I like it.
Punching out.
All right, brother. Yeah, so
why is he not coming down?
Because he doesn't want to be shocked.
Well, he can say no. He can say no.
And I really don't want us to have to go, oh, no.
It's
this thing.
Sam told me to shut the fuck up, and Eric said go away.
Here comes Eric.
Here comes.
There comes Eric.
All right. Iraq is waddling his way down the hallway.
Thank you, creepy voice.
Really? What a ghoul. He gets no respect.
He called him a ghoul?
He gets no respect.
He's
so
the worst voice ever.
Here.
Iraq. Blah, 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 blah. All right, we got Tits McGillicuddy coming in studio.
Come on, virus. Get in here.
Well, you got to call for him.
Hey, virus.
Virus!
Here he is.
Here's the virus. Hi, virus.
How you doing, virus?
What's going on, virus?
What's up? How you doing today?
I hear you're not happy.
No, not really.
That doesn't sound like the virus
No,
to me.
Not really.
Why aren't you happy, virus?
Not looking forward to getting shocked by a dog collar.
Well, if you have a punchline for a joke, you won't get shocked.
Yeah, that's fair, right, virus?
We throw a subject out that's, topical, something newsworthy.
I know how this bit goes.
All right, for the listeners out there. And then you come up with some kind of witty little anecdote about the situation.
Right,
put it on your calf.
Calf.
All right, so the virus is putting the dog shock collar
on his calf.
On his calf. And, it's fair, Anthony. If the virus comes up with a punchline, we don't shock him.
Right.
On the back of the meaty
How many
part?
Seconds do we
yeah,
give him before
part
we shock
of the
him?
Back.
One.
One second.
No, I give him a couple.
You give him the warning, the buzzer.
We'll give him 30 seconds. That's more than fair. Yep. 30 seconds is plenty of time for the virus to come up with a punchline on
right,
a current topic.
There he is.
And in 30 seconds, if he doesn't, Patrice hits him with what? A seven?
No, no, start with a one.
Fuck the one.
No, you work your way up.
Fuck the one.
I think you got to start with four.
I say start with two and work your way up.
All right.
What are you doing? Adjusting the...
He's making sure it's on.
Oh, it's on. And make sure it's on his leg, too.
Yeah, he'll cheat and put it on his fucking ankle bone.
It's like falling off. What that's all about.
The virus.
The virus. This is great. Love the virus. Videotape this. This has to be taped.
Patrice
Everyone's got their camera.
Patrice is trying to put this around the poor dumb animal.
Yeah. All right, that's good. That's on. Oh shit! What's wrong with your leg? Pull it up high, like above the.
Exactly.
Jesus Christ! Slipping on the mayo. Oh
Mayo joke.
They always
fire. Let me see if it's on.
Fires, move a little closer to everybody, right between Jimmy and Patrice. Sure
the thing is, put your leg so I can hear the thing.
The warning buzzer.
Why don't you cuff your pants up here?
Yeah, all right, the buzzer's on.
Cuff your pants so we can see that beautiful gam.
Yeah, there it goes. There's the virus. All right.
Oh, my God.
Hold on.
All right. Are we ready?
Yeah, yes, I think we are.
Are you really going to start with what?
What do you want me to start with?
Yeah, we got to start
at least
high.
Five.
Okay. Yeah, we got to start high. It's got to be... You can't lull him into it.
Well, should we start with three just to know it's on?
Yeah, I think so. Sure.
Hit him with a three right now.
You felt it?
Yeah, but not enough for it to be a punishment.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. You got
to go five.
Crank it up.
Okay.
All right, here's the virus. He's got the dog shot collar around his leg. He's got 30 seconds to come up with a punchline on a current topic. If he doesn't, Patrice hits him with the voltage. Right?
Yeah, what if it's just... What if he just does, like, with sometimes a quarterback's being rushed and they just throw the ball down to the ground?
I know.
What if he just pops something out of his mouth?
We'll make the intentional grounding call.
Honestly, yeah. Patrice is the executioner. If you don't think it's a...
Oh, no!
If you don't think it's a legitimate punchline, then you hit him.
This is a fucking vault. This is... You know what kind of execution this is? What? This fucking is a firing squad. Eight people got a fucking blank.
I agree.
And one person has the bullet.
All right, that's fair.
I am not going to judge this. This is a fucking room judge.
But it has to be a legitimate punchline.
Okay.
Even if it's all not right. good, it's okay. How about let's give a subject. What do you think?
Yeah, Jimmy was just on Leno, so you know all the current topics you guys were messing with, Jimmy.
Carrie Prejean.
This
is the Miss USA.
Miss USA. She's got some
marriage,
sex tapes.
Right.
And,
very insulted on Larry King, and now it turns out she's got a lot of sex tapes. A lot of pictures out there.
All right.
What do you got on that virus?
Go. There, I'm looking at the clock. 30 seconds. There's 5 seconds ticking by.
Sex tapes. Would you watch them?
Yeah.
Got 30 seconds, which is already half over.
Someone says, hey, I got the Carrie Prejean sex tape. You want to watch it?
Yep.
Would you watch it?
Here we go.
Yes, I would.
All right, he's got 10 seconds to come up with a punchline. Right, 10 seconds.
30 seconds goes fast. It's five
now.
He's
got 5 seconds.
Three, two.
And what does the virus have? No punchline.
The virus has learned.
Yes. The virus has learned a valuable lesson.
Well, what sucks now, you got to move it up to six.
How about wait.
What? New rule.
New rule.
New rule.
We vote on the level of strength that he should be able to come up with a joke for this one. For instance, Carrie Prejean should have been a four.
Uh-huh.
Because that's... Nah. Okay. So,
yeah, but no one wants to see him shocked with a four. We want to see him shocked with a ten. Let's be honest with each other.
Let's give him the easier... The joke should be, or to come
the
up
higher
with.
The fucking
let's
setup.
Say if it was Lorena Bobbitt time. Lorena Bobbitt is a fucking 10.
I think you just move it up one more.
No, because
we can't give him a hard shot. I thought she was easy because she
that
just
was
happened.
Easy.
How about this one? This is a subject we did on the round.
No, they're all easy. So just fucking put it up one more and give him another easy one.
Here's what we did on this round table last night. It was, are Bert and Ernie gay? Because there's groups that have been asking, are Bert and Ernie gay?
Okay.
From Sesame Street, because these groups were saying that they're both men. Mm. So a bunch of jokes were written for that. So are Bert and Ernie gay? Should be the one.
Go.
Are Bert and Ernie gay? Virus? You got a punchline on that?
The virus.
People are talking about Bert and Ernie. What do you got?
Sesame Street.
Virus is a funny guy.
What do you got? He's got 30 seconds to come up with a punchline, or he gets shocked.
Yes, he does.
Actually, he's got about 10 seconds
right
now.
Come on, virus, go.
That's
joke.
10. Bert and Ernie, one punchline from the virus.
That's all you need is just to be able
to say
something.
You know who
they are? 3, 2, 1, 0.
Oh, well.
What happened there, virus?
Virus, all you have to do is come up with one punchline. That's it, and you don't get shocked. One more. I think you can only handle one more, Jimmy. Yeah. One more topic for the virus where he gets shocked.
Can you put this? Here's what I'll do. It's the same thing as dogs.
Yeah.
I'll put the thing, and 10 seconds left, We'll just
10 seconds to get the warning buzzer.
That's the warning buzzer.
But he has to have a mic by his mouth, though, in case he needs it.
Oh, shit.
Crank it up.
Yeah, just hold the mic. E-Rock. That's unbelievable.
Now crank it up another notch.
Yeah, okay. One more notch. This is it. This is the final one. That's fair.
Yeah, so you might as well go up a couple of notches.
What are you up to, Patrice?
That was on 7.
All right. Yeah. All right, he's got to go 8. But,
go to 8.
But you come up with a punchline, you don't get the 8. All right, Jimmy, give him the last subject. It's on 8 now.
What
8 out of 10.
Do last
the dog
night?
Shock collar.
It was, hold on. We did Walmart clothes. We did
Prejean.
Bert and Ernie.
Prejean.
A finger.
Oh, you don't want to hear that sound.
How about something easy? I'm trying to get something easy.
So wrong.
I don't even have a fucking hot topic.
Are you all right, Eric?
No.
I mean,
he's not happy.
Fucking, what's his name?
The virus.
The virus. I'm sorry, V. Yo, V. You okay?
Michael Jackson's movie.
Look at Steve making sure this movie doesn't drop dead.
How about Michael Jackson's movie?
Michael Jackson's movie.
All right, let's set this up. Virus, the Michael Jackson movie. You got 30 seconds to come up with any type of punchline about Michael Jackson. If you don't do it in 30 seconds, you get shocked with an 8 out of 10 on the dog shock collar. And go!
Time's a ticking.
Michael Jackson's
one punchline about Michael Jackson or Michael Jackson's movie.
Come on.
Don't dare yell out some hack Michael Jackson.
Come on.
15 seconds to go for one punchline from the virus.
Come on, virus.
You think you got one, virus?
There he goes.
Got one punchline about Michael Jackson or Michael Jackson's movie.
Oh, no.
4, 3, 2, 1.
hit him again. I can't. You okay? Virus, you okay?
Virus, you all right? What happened?
That hurt.
Virus, you okay?
Who would do this to their dog?
Virus
we
ain't talking.
Just did.
Virus, you all right?
You all right, Virus?
Yeah.
What's the matter?
What's going on?
That hurt?
Feels like you just got stabbed.
Well, if you fill in the virus character,
yeah,
which is
I
a
like
good
that.
Sign.
Thank you. All right, let's thank the virus.
Yeah, thank you, virus.
I guess we shouldn't give him one more for good measure.
No, we take it
just
off.
Keep shocking him until he takes the collar off.
Take it off.
Yeah,
virus.
Take it off.
Virus, take it off.
Yeah,
take off the
quick.
Virus, quick.
Because he's going to get you.
No, I can't.
You can't do it.
I fucking can't. Oh, Jesus. Oh,
that
my
looks
God.
Good.
Oh,
you got a couple of holes in your leg.
Oh, jeez.
Fucking virus.
Oh, no.
E-Rock.
Let it be known, by the way. I'm stepping out of character. E-Rock has never said no to us.
That's right.
He has done everything we've ever asked.
That's a great cop.
Until he asked him to fucking make us a DVD for Leno's people, and he gave us a CD.
Oh, that's right. E-Rock, what happened with that?
What?
When I wanted you to make a DVD last week, but you made a CD, audio. Remember I asked you to burn that thing?
Shock him, he's got a puzzle
case. No. The fucking DVD I gave you, the video.
I cut that up and I handed it to you.
Yeah, but you made the CD.
If this was N.E.W., would you put it on his neck, Hobie?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I was going to put it on his neck today. I haven't learned any lessons. These guys keeping the show sane.
All right. I'll do one on the neck, but it can't be at 8.
All right, 9. Oh, you were staying the other way. All right.
Wait, is this an encore?
Steve is outside on the ground doing the curly from the Three Stooges behind his
shit. What? Fucking it.
What? It's up to you, man. You can say no.
Are you stopping this bitch?
No, I'm not stopping.
Here, move the mic. We're getting crazy feedback. Right. Get rid of one of those mics.
Why would you do it on your neck?
Because he's.
Why do you want to do
it? He wants to be a hero.
The back or the front?
Any part doesn't matter.
Dude,
how are we
going to
get this collar around
know.
That big neck of yours?
It'll go, but dude, this is not Patrice O'Neill's call. I'm visiting. I'm just promoting the Stress Factory.
Move the mic away.
What's that, E-Rock?
Just dump it. What are you saying, E-Rock?
He was shocked pretty good on his leg, I think.
Oof. Yeah, I think we did. You know, this is where we always fuck up. You know what? This is where we always fuck up. We got a good reaction.
Exactly.
Everyone got good video.
We want to take it to that next step.
You're right.
And the next step is usually right out the fucking door.
We just learned.
So let's just leave it at that.
Just leave it.
E-Rock.
The thought of, E-Rock did a good job. Here's what we just did. We reached the crossroad right there in that decision. One was right here where we are.
Mm-hmm.
The other crossroad, the one we didn't take, is us going, oh my God, waiting for an ambulance to revive a dead E-Rock on the floor.
On his neck.
And us going, oh my God, we did it again. The calls were Bob, that, we need an investigation, we're fired, shock jocks, shock their fucking employees.
You know,
it was a whole big thing.
You would be heroes.
No, we would be
to PETA.
Alternate universe.
Anthony.
We went to an alternate universe.
Dr. Steve texted me, no neck.
Well, okay. While he was on the floor,
he was
though,
just talking about E-Rock, calling him no neck.
But they made it. They made it for fucking dogs,
right?
Yeah.
It's not like their fucking makeup is any. They have voice
kinda,
boxes.
Kind of is, and like if the dog dies when you fucking hit it, it's not that big a deal.
Wait, you can't bury dogs
in your yard.
I was going to say that thing. The difference, you could just bury it in the backyard. No one will know the difference.
The cops aren't going to show up with forensics and figure out what happened to the dog.
Right.
There were two unusual marks in the dog's neck. We didn't know what it was.
All right.
DNA was found on the tips of the electrodes that matched a hippopotamus.
He took an eight. I wouldn't go past a seven.
No.
He took a fucking eight.
And I was scared because I might have high blood pressure. And that's why I was like, nah, this shit's probably, this has to be as much as one of those things they say, clear.
I think, what is it? High voltage, low amperage.
What's that mean?
What the fuck are you talking about, a mingler?
So that means you'll get the shock out of it, but it's not the amperage level's very low, so it doesn't kill you.
Is that what kills you,
amperage? That's what stun guns are. They're like, 10,000 volts, but the amperage is very, very low. But if you get
tell that to that fucking Russian dude in Canada.
Well, occasionally things do get fucked up.
Don't tase me, bro.
Don't tase me, bro.
Fuck all that, man. That shit is fuck that. I can't believe it. I'm sitting here going, I don't think a fucking person unless you if you did it to an old person.
Yeah.
But like I said, my dog was 8 months or some shit like that, and he's a pretty
young, vibrant dog.
He's one of those, and he's a what they call a hardy dog. Like he's a fucking, you could throw him against a wall, and he just try to chew through. It's just one of those dogs just keeps made to keep going.
Right. Tasmanian devil. Yeah.
And if the face he made, he's never made that face like of jeez. So he it hurts, man.
Yeah.
So he took an eight. Fucking God bless him. And he has big juicy meaty thighs.
Hell fucking yeah. All right. With that, let's take a break.